Has it been a week already? I've been stuck here in my studio preparing just to be ready for, well, this week. Mainly I've been looking through the barrage of services that are retiring soon, and not so soon, but that's not really very interesting. You know what is interesting though? Windows 11 and space computing, and both of which are in this episode. First though, if you like cloud news, why not check out some of the other shows? They are AWS This Week, GCP This Month, and Kubernetes This Month. And you can find the links to all of them in the description. Unless you've been on an internet ban, I'm guessing that you have heard that Windows 11 is on its way. This new version of Windows offers a refreshed user interface and many, many improvements, and is currently in preview. If you are eager to try it out, but don't have a spare device to install it on, or just not up for the risk of running a preview operating system, there is another way. Yes, Windows 11 Preview is now available on Azure Virtual Desktop, the 100% cloud-enabled service to run Windows from, well, anywhere, yeah. As with Windows 7, Windows 10, and Windows Server, you get, what? Yes, you can still run Windows 7. Well, I don't know why. Anyway, you can use Trusted Launch, also in preview, to enable TPM 2.0 and Secure Boot as part of the VM configuration to take full advantage of the security capabilities in Windows 11. One of the early issues with installing Windows 11 was the lack of TPM 2.0 in a lot of devices. So another good reason to try it out with Azure Virtual Desktop. Try it out today. Get some 11. Using the HPE Spaceborne Computer 2, a less than amazing name, Azure this week carried out an examination of high volume raw data, which was then processed all on the International Space Station. Using Azure in space saved a ton of bandwidth from the IIS down to Earth, as only the important parts identified had to be transmitted. Very neat. As Microsoft says, we are empowering developers to build for space at a speed that's out of this world. Great pun there. Well done, Microsoft Marketing. This is the culmination of a 4-year project to enable efficient compute resources in space, making it feasible to carry out large experiments with the use of cloud technology, even though it's above the clouds. Anyway, this is a great step towards space travel, I hope. Finally, a small but important update. Azure Kubernetes Services now support Kubernetes version 1.21, and this includes 50 enhancements and 19 brand new, shiny, fresh smelling features too. These include immutable secrets and config maps, IPv4 and v6 dual stack support, graceful node shutdown, less build maintenance, and a whole lot more. Consider upgrading your pods and clusters today, and then have popcorn to celebrate, obviously. Have you already tried out Windows 11, or is now the time to do it with Azure Virtual Desktop? Let me know in the comments what you like and don't like. Or what about space computing? Are you as excited as I am? Okay, let me know by clicking subscribe if you've tried Windows 11, and if you like space computing, then click like. Well, why not both? As we say on the A-Cloud Guru team, just before the launch of another ACG rocket to the outer Milky Way to test our space computing capabilities, seek and you shall cloud. So see you next week, and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.